Hello children, so in the last video we have completed till here the entire of the entire community, page number 52, chapter number 6. So now I will start from here. Clean surroundings keep diseases away and help everyone in a community to stay healthy. If our surroundings will be clean, so we will always be staying healthy. Therefore, the work of a community cleaner is no less important than the work of a doctor does. So the community cleaner is no less important than a doctor does. Here, community cleaner is also a kind of a doctor which keeps our community clean and makes us healthy. We should respect all kinds of work and all the community helpers who do different kinds of work to ensure that the community stays healthy, stay safe, fit, and can develop well. Now, we should always have respect towards our community helpers. Why? Because they keeps our community healthy, safe, and fit so that we can develop nicely. The respect we give to each community helper for the work he or she is called dignity of labor. Now, the respect which we give to our community helpers for the work they do is called as dignity of labor. Please underline this sentence from here till here. It means that by respecting them for the work they do or the labor they provide, we as the community treat them with a dignity as one of us and as a very important part of community. Now, what does this dignity of labor means? That it means we should respect them for the work they do or the labor they provide us. We as the community treat them with dignity. We should treat them with dignity as one of us and as a very important part of the community. See here, like doctors, what they do? They are doing what kind of things? They make the people healthy. Community cleaners, they make our surroundings clean. Then there are different kinds of community helpers. So they all in together, if they will not work, we will not be able to stay in a comfort zone. So if they are working, we are staying in a comfort zone. So we should have a dignity of labor towards them. We should always respect them, what the work they are doing or the labor they are providing us. Now, the next topic is safety against exploitation. While work is important for all, there are certain occasions where people are forced to work against their will. When something like this happens, it is not work anymore. It is not work anymore, but exploitation of a human being. Now, what is this written? While work is important, everybody knows that work is very important. There are certain occasions where people are forced to work against their will. There are certain occasions where the people are forced. The government is forcing the people to work against their will. If they don't want to work, still they are forced to work. When something like this happens, it is not It is not work anymore, but exploitation of human being. When someone is not willing to do anything and still he or she is forced to do that work, that is called as exploitation of a particular human being. This happens most often when the little child who should be going to school to study and play are forced to work in factories, roadsides, tea stalls, dhabas, in our homes and in many places. Usually such children come from very poor families and their parents do not earn enough to provide them with good food or to send them to school. Now, which kind of people are exploited? There are small children. Small children, you have seen, they are roadside, they are there. They don't have enough food to eat. Sometimes they don't have food also to eat, and they don't go to school. Why? Because their parents are very poor and they can't afford them to go to school, so they are forced to work in the factories, roadsides, the tea stalls, the dhabas, in all these kinds of places they are forced to work. But in this small age, they are not allowed to go to school and study and play. Why? Because their parents are very poor. Often such children are forced by either parents or some other elder to start working somewhere to earn money for the family. Now, either they are forced by the parents or they are forced by the elder ones. Why? Because if they will earn money, so they will have one time of food. However, when children work, they can be exploited. When the children are working, they are being exploited. They are not grown up and they can be made to work for long hours and paid very little money. Now, when the children are working for long hours, but they are paid very little money. They may not be even be given food or allowed a break. Sometimes what happens where they are going for job, sometimes they don't get food also and they are not getting a single break also. Still they are doing their jobs because they have to earn money for their family. They are often scolded or beaten if they protest. Now, if they are not liking it and if they are protesting this, saying that I will not do that, they can be the people are scolding them or they are beating them also. This is not a good habit. Sometimes children from poor families are kidnapped and sold to factories and other places where they are made to work under terrible condition and for no money. Now, sometimes what happens? The small children are being kidnapped and they are sold to some factories or places where they are made to work under terrible condition for no money. This kind of things are also happening in our India. So we should always be aware of that. We should not talk to any person to whom you don't know. India has very strong rules or laws that do not allow children below the age of 14 to work. Now, India has been made a law that under the age of 14, no child will be working. Older children aged between 14 and 18 are allowed to work only in certain safe and protected places. Now, those who are between the age of 14 and less than 18, they are allowed to work in a certain places which are safe and protected. Therefore, when people make children below the age of 14 work or children below the age of 18 work in hazardous places, it is known as child labor or exploitation of children, which is a crime under the law of India. Now, when the children are working under the age of 14 or below the age of 18, in the different kinds of places which are not eligible for them. These kinds of things are known as labor. This is called as child labor or exploitation of children, and this is under the crime law of India. It is important to protect the little children and inform the police whenever we see someone exploiting a child and treating him or her badly. Now, if you see any kind of children which are smaller and where the people are not treating them politely and they are beating or they are scolding them and they are exploiting them, so you should inform to the police. Little children can be protected and be kept safe only if each of us stay aware and try to prevent their exploitation. So what is this written? Little children should be protected. How they will be protected? Only if each of us stay aware. We should be always aware of the things which are going in our surroundings. So we should try to prevent this kind of exploitation. Now, here we have completed a chapter. One value is given. We should treat all community helpers with love and respect. Without their help, our lives would be not comfortable at all. I already told you that we should always treat all our community helpers with love and respect, whether it is a doctor or a carpenter or a plumber or electrician or a soldier. We should always respect them. And without them, without their help, our life would not be comfortable. So here we have ended the chapter. In the next chapter, I will be providing you the exercise and the question answers part. Till then, please read the chapter again and try to understand the main parts which is being underlined. Thank you, children.